Oh, look at that. Inigo, look at that. That's a table full of all kinds of golden loot. If possible, we can see if we can take all that. I don't see anybody here, so I think it might be okay. Nobody down there either. Right, Inigo. We need to. Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. Okay, Inigo, keep me covered. I'm gonna go through this place a little bit and see if we can take whatever we can. Anything on the shelves we can take? Nothing amazing, nothing good. All right, let's get up on the table. See what we've got here. Bread, don't need. Coinpurse, I'll take. Septums, I will take as well. It's not letting me take them for some reason. Hey, good, now I can. Septum, I'll take. Septum. Coin purse, septum, another coin purse. That's gonna be so many things here. Search chest, this mini chest. I'll take all this. That's an apprentice. I will see if I can unlock it, but I don't think we have good enough lock picking skill. Okay. Open this. Orcish arrows, lock picks, and septums. Okay, well that's good. What have we got to be here? Another chest to unlock. Good. Darwin's bones, septums. I'll take the
You
bow.
have a gift, my friend, and a lot of lockpicks to fall back on.
Yeah, we've been able to collect them. We can actually also make them if necessary, which is going to be really good for us later down the line. Really, really good. Okay. I think this might be one of the exits we can take through here. Oh. I saw a skeever there. Didn't see us, I don't think. So took a shot. Let's see if this is an exit from this place. I wonder if we can exit through here. Might just have to come back, to be honest. I don't see anything right now, so I think we're okay. Okay, let's keep on going then. Don't know if this is the right place to go to. I generally don't know. Okay, well, it looks like there might be some sort of a side passage here. I wonder what this will take us to. The right way warrants. Let's see on the map. It tells me I need to go back to the Ragged Flag in order to exit, so I think I will do that. I don't think there's any reason for me to explore this further area. I mean, we already, came here what we needed for. We took the bow, so we should probably come back to the right owner and bring it back. See if we can do that first. Did get a lot of loot though, I won't lie, we did get a lot of loot. Like both the monetary value and the items we can carry. So I should probably find a Khajiit merchant to sell stuff too. See, the good part about Khajiit merchants is they will mostly trade everything and anything they have and anything that you have. It just they don't have the same amount of gold that I guess a regular merchant would have. So we have to like sell some things, but we have to buy some things in order to create a proper balance. But hey, a give or take balance system would not be that big of a problem for me, Because then we can take the things that we do need, like sapphires or fire salts, and we can sell the things that we don't need, like all the weapons that I can't use or the weapons that are not, not enough for me. Also, some things that are enchanted that we don't particularly need, we can also sell and make a pretty penny off of it, which would be really, really nice. Because there's no way we can make a major profit on Rift, and not with the declining economy that the place has. So anyway, let's see if we can get out the.
Stay out of trouble, or there's gonna be trouble.
Okay, well, I'll keep that in mind. I will not go to Ragged Flagon next time then. Ragged Flagon seems like a very shady place. Well, probably these operations have commence mostly. So we're gonna try to avoid this place as best as possible. What's the one way to get out here? I think. We had a bridge over here. There we go. Take this bridge across, and we'll find our exit somewhere through here. There we go. There you go. Perfect. Find the exit. That's what we needed to use a drawbridge to get back here as soon as possible. And head over to the farmer and present them with their bow that they so much desire. So anyway, I'll be right back. I'll be come back as soon as we get back to the farmer. If anything happens in between, I'll make sure to show that, and I'll see you in a little bit. Okay, and hello. Are they? Oh.
I can smell things growing.
I can smell things growing too, as well, Inigo. I'm guessing those two are bodyguards, just like I guess Inigo is our bodyguard. Except we don't have to actually pay him. He just, you know, owes his life to us. Which is fine, you know, which is cool. Hey, how's it going? I brought your bow back.
So, has my bow turned up yet?
Yes, there it is.
That's it. You found it. I don't know how you got it back, and I don't want to know. Frankly, I don't even care. I'm just so glad to see it again. Here, this is all I can afford to give you as compensation. Hope it's enough. Until next time.
Three garnet, flawless garnet, and ruby. You know what? That's actually not too bad. Although he can't afford his gold, he will take the gems and we'll, you know, do something with them, gladly. No problem, that actually sounds perfect. I didn't really pay attention to the Kashidi merchants, but let me check to see if they're still there. Oh yeah, they are! Wow! I completely ran past them, to be honest. Well, here they are, we'll be able to actually sell some things that we don't need, and hopefully they'll be able to buy it. Hi, how's it going? Hmm? And there is Akari, hello.
So many refuse to talk to us. They call us thieves and smugglers. I am glad to see that you are not such a one.
We would never want to, you know, we would never want to betray our own kind. And, you know, we'll take care of business, even though some things are a little shady.
Take a look.
Let's see what we got here. First of all, we're going to sell the things that we don't need. Ebony arrows I'll keep because Inigo actually had, you know, we could probably give them back to Inigo. Imperial arrow bow we will not need. Iron arrows we'll still take because it still doesn't hold any weight. It does okay damage and we just have a lot of it. Iron dagger we don't need. Iron war axe of ice blast we will not need. Or really the great sword of drafts. So I think we're going to stick with one-handed weapons for now. Orcish arrows will keep, Orcish bow will keep, dagger will keep. Mace of burning is good to have still, so we'll take that. Pickaxe is always good, necessary for our endeavors. Steel bolts we will keep, steel dagger we can sell, steel war axe we can sell. That's good for the weapons. Regarding armor, Akatosh, I feel like having amulets with us would be good, just in general, so we can mix and match them. Bandit our armor of appetite. I feel like we could probably sell it for a lot more to somebody else. Dawnguard armor we can actually sell right now, to be honest. But I feel like bandit armor we could sell for a pretty penny now, instead of maybe selling it to an appraiser, right? Or we could disenchant it. Although we're not much of an enchanter, I think we really will not have a lot of use with it, so unfortunately we're gonna sell it. Let's see here, Dawnguard helmet we'll keep, just in case to keep ourselves protected. Face mask is always good to have. Yep, we're gonna keep this. Gloves of the Pugilist we'll keep because having, you know, something to wear in order to protect us in this kind of situation would be good to have. Gold necks we can sell. High braces of archery, I think we'll keep that. That's actually really good. Or we can give to Inigo. I'm pretty sure he wouldn't mind that, you know, a slight boost in his damage. Smithing we'll keep. Sure grip we will sell because we're not gonna be wielding two-handed weapons. But we'll keep. Only has 167 gold, that's fine, it's okay. And iron gauntlets we'll keep for ourselves in case we want a smith ever. See, and now at the moment, they don't really have the money to, you know, sell us anything more. So I wonder if we could maybe buy some things from them that we do actually require and need. Nothing regarding weapons or apparel, at least I don't think so. 10% less damage when health falls below. Oh, nice, actually, that's cool. We could get backpack or brown for it, give it to Inigo. Yeah, it's actually be kind of good. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's give it to, we're gonna give it to Inigo. What else do we have here at the moment if that we can take by any chance? Gain 30% more experience. That actually doesn't sound too bad with this kind of gloves. But overall, I think I'm okay. Potions, I don't think we need to worry about anything at the moment. The Rue of Skooma. They do have Skooma. We'll probably not buy it. Ingredients, Moon Sugar, Miscellaneous? I wonder if I have, like fire salts and stuff. Garnet, they have those. Gold high, grand soul gem, ice wolf pelt, iron ore, strips, lockpicks. We could take, you could actually buy all the lockpicks, why not? That's pretty good. Okay, so they don't have any sapphire, sadly. We're gonna go back here and actually sell some things now that have a lot more, you know, money to afford. We'll sell one of these, and we're gonna sell the steel Nordic gauntlets. Good. Ring of fortitude we'll keep. There you go. Alright, good. I think we accomplished a, you know, a solid trade here. I like this.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Hi.
Let's see here. Ah, a letter from the Jarl. Moving up in the world, eh? Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Letter from the Jarl.
My bones ache for the moon sugar. It has been too long since I tasted it.
You know that our supply is limited. It could be a season or more before we get a new shipment from the south.
My ears hear the truth in your words, and yet my body shakes with the need.
Control yourself. Do not frighten away our customers with your fits.
Yes, of course, you are right. Still, I would give much for even a few grains of moon sugar.
Put the thought out of your mind, and do not speak of it again.
Yeah, a lot of Khajiit are plagued with addiction of skooma of moon sugar. It's kind of been destroying a lot of the families and societies. At the same time, it has also, you know, spread the corruption for the people elsewhere. Let's see. A letter from the Yar, right? I received a letter from the Yar. Also, I got a lot of spell tomes. I don't think I can really use Bone Spirit. Cast a vegetable spirit that homes in on your target and explodes. Okay, we can take that. Alarm, I guess. Let's see. Response to better speech. Letter from Jarl Falkreath. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Sidgir, and I have the honor to be the Jarl of the proud of ancient city of Falkreath. The fame of your exploits across Skyrim has brought you to my attention. If you're interested in becoming a Thane of Falkreath, hold, I invite you to speak with me next time you are in Falkreath. Aside from the honor that accrues to the title, my Thanes are entitled to personal house carls. Also, I can tell privately the choice parcel of land in Falkreath will be available for your purchase if a service, should your service prove useful to me. I look forward to meeting you in person. I remain Jarl Sidgir Falkreath. Huh. So looks like people have been hearing about adventures there. I'm guessing the word of a small Khajiit kid that smuggles things in maybe spread a little bit, and people are interested in having somebody like that around? Possibly? I mean, I guess we're not really a smuggler, we're more of a carrier. More like a very efficient and, I guess, battle-ready courier service. And the courier is really just, you know, sending letters and things, but we are battle efficient and can actually carry out certain tasks. I'm guessing we have been noticed a little bit. I never really heard a lot about, you know, Falkreath, so maybe we could check out that place eventually. For now though, I think it might be a cool idea to explore a little bit more of the land, you know, just lay of the land and all that. Maybe explore up to the mountain here and get into the cave, check out what's inside and what's in store for us, maybe for later. Also just kind of see what the place has. Oh lord. Okay, Inigo, please help. Please help, Inigo. Oh god. Inigo, help. Oh god. Jesus. Thank you, Inigo. Jesus Christ, I'll take the pelt. Good lord. Okay, well, I should be a lot more prepared next time. I just ran up here without thinking. Maybe there could be something here. I just literally ran over here. Seeing what's going on. Holy hell. Skeleton, septum, bone meals. I guess we take bone meal. Don't know what could be used for. Got a coin purse. We have a amulet of Zenithar, a satchel with lockpicks and septums, and shrine of Zenithar. Are the blessings removed? Blessing of Zenithar added. What is Zenithar? I never learned about this stuff. Let me check it out here. Blessing of Zenithar. Which one is it again? What is Zenithar do? Smithing novice, you can create steel and bone. Never mind, that's not it. Increase capacity, fortify warmth, carry weight. Is that it? Scaled armor of the traveler, no, backpack, brown fur. Blessing of Zenithar, prices are 10% better. Oh! Oh, that's actually gonna be good, if possible. I feel like, since we got the amulet of Zenithar, price at 10% better. Okay! Well, that's actually good to have. I wonder if we can put on, yeah, we can put on multiple necklaces. Okay, I'll put on this. Magicka, we don't use Magicka. Spells, we don't use Restoration spells. I do have a ring I need to put on here. Now that I have the ability to put on multiple accessories, I will wear two necklaces, one of Zenithar and one of Arcay. Arcay will increase our health, and Zenithar will increase our prices when it comes to, you know, bargaining and doing some mercantile work, which is going to be really good for us later down the line. Really, really good for us. We're about to be more efficient when it comes to buying and selling things for ourselves and for our suppliers. It's gonna be really good for us. Alright, anyway, well, good thing I discovered about the shrine, otherwise I would have never known that would be there. Let's go and head down the hill here and start exploring this hill. There's also a camp up there, which I should investigate. But I do want to see what's going to be going on this way. We got, looks like a mountain and a mine. Be cool to investigate those. I think, and a spriggan over there. Yep, I see a spriggan. They're going invisible for some reason. I mean, that is a spriggan over there. They have gone invisible. I wonder if it would be possible for us to hunt down a spriggan. They don't seem to notice us, so I think if we attack them from the from afar, we might actually get a critical hit. Okay, good. Nice! Awesome. Thank you, Inigo. Alright, let's see if you can, that's a deer. Wait, that's... Did we kill a deer or did we kill a Spriggan? Oh, there's a deer and a Spriggan here. Oh. I have a taproot. I'm not sure what taproot could be used for. But hey, we'll take it. What do we got with the deer here? We could take the hide and venison. I guess we could take the venison. Maybe cook it later. So we got a hunter. Oh. Oh, so that's probably what the Spriggan was trying to kill here earlier. The hunter must have killed the, must have killed the moose. And then Spriggan must have killed the hunter. He has a lot of supplies. Take some of it. I don't want to carry all of it. Got only limited space. By the way, talking about Inigo.
What is on your mind?
I need to give you something, actually.
Pooling our resources.
A little bit. And also, I want to provide you with a present of a very helpful item. Back program fur, there you go.
You have some moon sugar, I see. Are you planning on making some elsewhere fondue? It is pretty tasty stuff. Not that I would want any.
I guess we do have some moon sugar. I don't know much about elsewhere fondue, but maybe we could do something with that. So rabbit here. Oh god, the head is twisted. Is this rabbit okay? Look at its head, it's twisted backwards. Oh, Jesus. Spriggan must have hit really hard. Gee, okay, well that's very lovely. Poor little rabbit. Didn't deserve that. Let's see if we can head over to the cave instead then. We got a couple of places to explore through here. I feel like we should start with the cave first, and then we can start with the mine afterwards. Oh, shit. The hell is going on here? Got a lot of blood. First of all, we got feet. We got blood. Follow Stone Cave discovered. What the hell is going on here? Well, Inigo, I don't know how you feel about this, but I'm about to go into something absolutely terrifying. Well, I guess next episode I know what we're going to be exploring. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks so much for watching. Really hope you enjoyed. My name is Samuel. Like, subscribe, and as always, have a great day. I'll see you all next episode as we explore the inside of Fallow Stone Cave. That should be interesting. Okay. A little creepy, but I think we can do this. Yeah, no problem. Let's go for it. Alright, we've entered the Fallow Stone Cavern with Inigo. We're arriving here for the first time ever. Now, I don't know what exactly to expect here, which is why this is a little bit nerve-wracking. Like, we don't even have a quest here. We're just exploring this place to see what we can find. I might have my bow out just in case, though. See some bones. I'm gonna predict there's either a troll that lives here, or maybe a family of zebra cats. Maybe. Because I don't know what else could be causing such a bloody mess outside. Okay, I'm gonna go through here. See, I think more bones? No, that's a spider! Oh yeah, that's a spider. See a tree. We found a giant spider. I'm not sure how many of them there are there. I'ma try to take a shot at it. Okay, frostbite spiders. Oh god. Oh lord. Okay. I did not expect so many of them to be there. Okay, Inigo, help. Inigo, help. You help, Inigo. There you are. Nice. Okay. Well, I did not expect that to happen, you know, to be here. Spiders still, to this day, freak me the hell out. And especially giant spiders like this. Oh, did not mean to do that. I guess Kyro didn't like the spiders either. Just wanted to bang one of them. Okay. I don't see anything from here. God, this cave is huge. What is here? It's like, what could be over here? You know, what could be so big on over here, though? Jesus, wow, it's actually a lot bigger than I thought it would be. Alright, Inigo, let's keep exploring through here and see if we can find anything at all, anything useful. Primarily looking for ore, if possible. If not ore, we're looking for any kind of loot. If not loot, maybe a resource that we can collect through here? Maybe that's primarily what we're after. Gotta be careful and look out for them. Oh, did I mean to do that? Gotta be careful and keep looking out for them spiders, just in case. Don't see any around here. I guess we can jump down. Start making our way slowly through here. Yeah, I don't see anything. I know there's spider webs here, which means we're gonna run into a bunch of spiders. There's a cave over here. I wonder if there's a spider in there. Let me actually use a... I'm gonna use a set of weaker arrows that I don't particularly need. Some iron arrows. I'm gonna use one of those and see if it can make a sound and attract it. Oh, Jesus. Indigo scared the hell out of me there. We're gonna see if it can attract a spider if they're in this cave. None. Okay. Well, let's explore inside here then. Okay, I see a person. Okay, looks every good. What do we got here? Bandit, garnet, lockpick, septums, everything else not really necessary, not really needed. Quick save. Also, I completely forgot that I have some braces that I probably should be wearing from now on. These braces are going to be a lot better for us. They hide braces of archery. They'll make us make sure that our bows, our bow attacks do a lot more damage than they currently do. And let's go ahead and equip our regular arrows here. I believe we have some steel arrows. There we go. Plenty of steel arrows. Good. Let's keep going through here. There's a tree in the very center, right? That tree. I don't know why it's highlighted the way it is. I mean, it looks gorgeous, right? That bird's all over here. Probably made a nest up there. The tree looks really serene. The entire ground over there looks extremely serene. It's the fact that there's spiders all over the place, which is why I'm very cautious. Go ahead and see if we can nab that one. Good, nice. Any more spiders notice anything? Nope. No spiders notice a thing. I'm gonna try to make a range attack on the spiders really far away. I don't think this would be the right angle. I think if we go like lower down like this, we might be able to get them. Nice, very nice. Alerted more spiders in the area. Good. I think, oh, they killed it, nice, okay. Wow, we're actually getting good at this. The new bracers is damn good. I'm gonna make my way to the right first. We're gonna look out for any spider within the area. I wonder if night eye would help me see better. Maybe a little bit. Everything does look a lot brighter, so might be easier to see a spider, like that thing over there. Getting surprisingly good at this. We're getting surprisingly good at this. Right, down the tree we go. I'm gonna stick to the right for now, right? I'm gonna stick to the right. Look out for any spiders up ahead of us. Okay, nothing so far. I don't see anybody. Take this. Inigo, is he behind us? Inigo? Inigo? Where are you? Where'd he go? There he go. Oh. Huh, I guess he's stuck somewhere. Okay, well, let's keep moving forward then. And try to hope that we won't get killed out here. Okay. I believe we killed all the spiders in the center here. This is a cool looking cave. I love it. I love the structures as well. So wish I knew what it meant. We'll take the venom. Take the venom. Good. We can always reuse the venom to something else. Huh. Got some bones here. So people and several large creatures have died here before. See, is that a spider? No, it's not a spider. It's just trees moving around. Okay, I say I'll just keep on going through here then. We got, I believe, is that ore by the way? Oh, it is! It's iron ore! Okay, sweet, let's go ahead and loot it up real quick. See, I knew we were gonna need, you know, I knew we were gonna find some sort of ore here. That's good. As long as we could find, you know, something to take back with us and smelt later on, that'd be wonderful. We could make some things here and there, maybe lockpicks, mostly. There you go, some ore added, no ore vein is depleted. I may have to walk around here a little bit later, see if we can find more ore veins. But I think for now we might be okay. Let me go ahead and go through here then. Let's see, ore. Not too much ore. It's not really a mine, it's just a regular cave. So, its focus is not going to be on the ore, but we can find plenty of ore. Look at this. I'm just going to go ahead and just do it by hand here. There we go, it's going to be a lot faster. And Inigo appears. Hi. Smells like you just aren't getting here. Maybe a little bit. I think this one, oh no, not depleted yet. Good, now it's depleted, and we got this one over here. The silver ore mine. Let's go ahead and bash on this real quick. See what we can nab. Some silver ore, good. Is it depleted? Oh yeah, it's depleted now. Alright. Well, see, this is actually kind of good that we can run and recollect all this ore around here. I mean, nobody else is gonna, you know, go find and go look for it. So it's best we nab it whenever we can, since, you know, since I guess we kind of have a lay of the claim on it. Alright, well, that's all over for now. Let's see if we can take whatever we can give you. Frostbite, I'll take that. Venom. Okay, so I believe there are a couple more areas we can explore still in this cave. All we know is we're dealing with spiders. If you're dealing with spiders, as long as we stay stealthy and stay away from the spiders, you know, keep a nice range from them, don't let them poison us, I think we should be A-okay. I believe there might be a way for us to travel further down in the cavern here to keep exploring. So let's do that. I'm gonna stick to the right side, which is a little bit more dry. Some birds and bats. Okay, cool.